the International Conference on Primary Healthcare held in Alma-Ata in 1978, organized by the World Health Organization, strongly reaffirmed that health is a fundamental human right and that the attainment of the highest possible level of health is the most important worldwide social goal. It also prompted action in many other social and economic sectors in addition to the health sector to reach this goal. The conference also set a goal of achieving health for all by 2000 AD. 2000 AD has come and gone. While the health for all goals has been marginally achieved, in many areas there exists a widening gap. The process of globalization, liberalization and privatization, which began in the 90s, further widened the gap and led to commodification of healthcare. The commodification of healthcare led to non-affordability of quality healthcare and out-of-pocket expenditure for millions, which has become the second main reason for poverty in our country. Despite a strong pressure to change the direction of the health services in the country, all the negative trends that the expert group of the Indian Council of Social Science Research, ICSSR, and the Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, noted, such as top-down, elite-oriented, urban-based, centralized and bureaucratic, continue to plague delivery of healthcare in this country. This group prepared a report on an alternative strategy on health for all, which also served as a precursor to the National Health Policy of 1983. The committee emphasized the need to reduce poverty and inequality and to spread education, to organize the poor and the underprivileged groups so that they are able to fight for their basic rights, and to move away from the counterproductive, consumerist Western model of healthcare and to replace it by the alternative model based in the community. This exhortation and inspiration led to the evolution of the Community Health Cell, CHC, in 1984, which became later the Society for Community Health Awareness Research and Action in 1991. The Society noted that the root cause of many illnesses faced by a majority in the country can be traced back to social, economical, political, cultural and ecological aspects, and cautioned against the biomedical, techno-managerialism that had dominated healthcare. This situation raised the need for a community-based approach to health and for a larger critical mass of people to work on equity-oriented community-led process, which became the objectives of the society. In 1986, Professor D. Banerjee of Jawaharlal University said, "Health service development is a socio-cultural, political, technological and managerial process with an epidemiological and sociological perspective." This was later further endorsed by Professor Geoffrey Rose, an eminent epidemiologist of London School of Hygiene and Tropical Medicine in 1992, who said, "The primary determinants of disease are mainly economic and social, and therefore its remedies must also be economic and social. Medicine and politics cannot and should not be kept apart." Both these further inspired the society to evolve a new community health-oriented paradigm of action. The need for community building was essential, since community is being distorted by development. There was also a need for socio-economic, political, cultural, and ecological analysis to understand the complexity of health and the need for young health professionals to be oriented to both community building and deeper understanding of social determinants and right to health. Thus, the Society for Community Health Awareness Research and Action, which began a community health exploration in 1984, evolved a Community Health Learning Program, CHLP, in 2003, to prepare young professionals to be responsive to all those unmet needs, to build community, to act on social determinants and community action in health, and to build a countervailing power from below to make health policy more people-oriented.
CHC and Sochara have innovated with different approaches to community health. And after 2 decades of working like this, we thought we would develop a program for young professionals, young persons who are enthusiastic to work
very early in their professional careers, must be exposed to these broader ideas and social determinants and the issues of rights and equity and quality, integrity and gender.
So that they could learn from the experience that has been gained so far and take this forward.
And since then, we have both promoting community health, learning about community health, and also training a new generation of health activists deeply committed to this new way of thinking.
And over the past 10 years, this has evolved into a larger program, both in Bangalore as well as in Bhopal, where many young professionals from multidisciplinary backgrounds come and spend a whole year going through a semi-structured process. We have 6 months where they learn theoretically through interactive sessions, and 6 months where they go to the field, work with communities, and then we discuss as a group what has been learned from the field and how things can be done perhaps differently, where community voice can be heard more strongly.
So the whole Paulo Freire approach to education, which is work, learning, sharing, creative thinking and so on, became the sort of philosophy in which all our learning programs began.
Mentoring is an important and unique feature of the community learning program. Each fellow is assigned a team mentor during the collective learning and a field mentor during the field work. We have over 50 field mentoring organizations across the country who support the field learning process. It's like a university without walls.
It's the relationship between the field mentor, the team mentor, the fellow, and the community that is the basic learning substrate.
This idea is also propagated through various national workshops that we hold and various other activities that we do. We also have mentors, meetings, and fellows, alumni. All these things are done to encourage practitioner-oriented thinking. So it is a combination of theory and praxis.
It is committed to a belief that persons, communities, and public are the focus. The transformation of public health system can happen only through transformed people at all levels. It focuses on linkages and outreach to vulnerable populations and disadvantaged regions of the country.
Now, the biomedical model, the model which focuses on doctors, drugs, hospitals, diseases, is very, very dominant, and everyone thinks of health in those sort of medical terms. And so we created, over the years as we evolved our work in Sochara, a new concept called a paradigm shift to understand this shift from a biomedical model to a social community model. Basically, it means that we are shifting an understanding of medicine to health by shifting the focus from individuals to communities. When we see people, we don't see them as patients, but we see them as participants of a program. When we think of a particular health challenge, we don't focus on drugs and technology and vaccines, but we focus on education and social processes that will help us to tackle those. When we look at even the research aspects, we will look not just at the pathological or the biological factor of disease, but we look at social, cultural, political, economic, ecological factors. And so this shift from looking at any health problem, whether it's HIV/AIDS, whether it's malaria, whether it's women's health, from a more medical model, we are shifting the paradigm to a social and community model, which has some of those determinants and some of those features that I've just mentioned.
The third phase of the program has evolved from the previous two phases through a process of review, reflection, analysis, and participation by the community health fellows. This has led to it being expanded and to being more structured while keeping the experiential focus very strongly at the center.
The CHLP continues to build capacities of individuals already working with or proposing to work with community-based organizations and health programs in the voluntary, development, and government sectors. Let us now listen to the voices of the fellows.
The whole ideology which Sochara follows is just synchronizing with me, with my ideology, and what I want to do in the field, and how do we understand the society is exactly matching with what Sochara's understanding, Sochara's analysis of the society. And this is the first organization in my life at the time of 2003-04 that who understand the issues from a people's perspective and from a right political perspective. So then I decided that I have to be here.
The CHLP program, first of all, it opened out this whole new world of people, projects, perspectives to me, and people who were pro-poor. And that really connected to me because I was looking for a place like that.
In the CHLP course, I was introduced to a very different kind of a classroom setting. Here, there was not like a typical teacher-student relationship. We were called fellow travelers in the community health journey, and they were facilitators, and we were the learners. And it was a very open environment to share ideas and our perspectives. And this was kind of a melting pot for ideas. And it was a really nice experience interacting with people from various different backgrounds.
I thought that after, you know, exit from that MSW profession, I can join the, some institutions and I can change the world like anything like that. But the world is not so easy. But when I reached Sochara, what I learned is like, okay, we can change, we can, you know, make changes in the world through small steps.
इसी के साथ जब मैं यहाँ पर आया तो मेरे जो कंसेप्ट था मेरे जहन में हेल्थ को लेकर, वो एक बहुत ही नैरो यानी बहुत संकीर्ण स्वास्थ्य को लेकर मेरे जहन में था. तो मैं उसी को लेकर जब चल रहा था तो फर्स्ट कलेक्टिव सेशन जो हुआ उसमें जो डिटर्मिनेंट्स ऑफ हेल्थ स्वास्थ्य के जो निर्धारक बताए गए तो उसको देख के मैं बहुत ही ज़्यादा कहना चाहिए कि परेशान हो गया. कि
जो मुझे लगा कि जो पहले हम थोड़ा बहुत कर रहे थे तो हमें लगा कि ये क्या कर रहे हैं, हमें हमारे समझ से भी लगता था कि शायद बायोमेडिकल क्षेत्र जो है दुनिया में चेंज लाने के लिए या गरीबों को ऊपर उठाने के लिए सबसे अच्छा अप्रोच है. लेकिन यहाँ आने के बाद या उससे पहले भी जो थोड़ा कर रहे थे और यहाँ आने के बाद मुझे पूरा तरह से स्पष्ट हो गया कि एक्चुअली अगर हम सचमुच में किसी को ऊपर उठाना चाहते हैं तो ये सोशल मॉडल या कम्युनिटी अप्रोच के तहत ही अच्छा होगा.
वो ननगंतरदे ई 9 ತಿಂಗಳ ಕಲಿಕೆ ನನ್ನ ಜೀವನದ ಒಂದು ದೃಷ್ಟಿಕೋನ ಬದಲಾಗಿದೆ. ನಾನು ಮುಂಚೆ ಕೆಲವೆಲ್ಲ ಹೋರಾಟಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಭಾಗವಹಿಸುತ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ಹೋರಾಟದಲ್ಲಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಘಟನೆ ಆಗಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ವಿಷಯದಲ್ಲಿ ಸತಿಗೂ ಆ ಹೋರಾಟದ ಮುಂಚೂಣಿಯಲ್ಲಿ ಇರ್ತಿದ್ದೆ. ನಾನು ಈ ಕಲಿಕೆ ನಂತರ ನನಗೆ ಅದು ಆ ಒಂದು ಹೋರಾಟದ ದಿಕ್ಕು ಬದಲಾವಣೆಯಾಗಿ ಒಂದು ವಕಾಲತ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾಧಾರಿತವಾಗಿ ಅಂದರೆ ಆ ವಿಷಯದ ಸಂಪೂರ್ಣ ಆಳವಾಗಿ ಅರಿತು ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಅದನ್ನ ಕುರಿತು ಮಾತಾಡುವಂಥ ಶಕ್ತಿ ಬಂದಿದೆ.
ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಮಟ್ಟದಲ್ಲಿ DHO ಅವರು ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಥವಾ ಜಿಲ್ಲಾ ಆಸ್ಪತ್ರೆಯ DS ಇರ್ಬೋದು, ಇವರ ಜೊತೆಗೆ ನಾನು ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಆರೋಗ್ಯ ವ್ಯವಸ್ಥೆ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಸುಧಾರಣೆ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಡೈಲಾಗ್ ಮಾಡಬಲ್ಲೆ, ಮಾತುಕತೆ ಮಾಡಬಲ್ಲೆ, ಮತ್ತು ಜನರ ಜೊತೆ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಮೂಮೆಂಟನ್ನು ಸಹ ಆಂದೋಲನವನ್ನು ಸಹ ಕಟ್ಟಬಲ್ಲೆ. ಅದಾದು ಆ ಥರದ ಒಂದು ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಈ ತರಬೇತಿಯಿಂದ ಬಂದಿದೆ.
Another aspect of the CHLP program which really inspired me was the whole academic cum activist environment which operates in Sochara. This really challenged me to take my whole knowledge, to examine my knowledge, to examine my stand on different issues and to take it forward.
Har course mein ek learning procedure to rehta hi hai. लेकिन CHLP की एक विशेषता ये है कि इसमें एक मिशन दिया जाता है, एक आपको एक एक्टिविस्ट प्लस स्कॉलर बनाए.
हियर इट इज़ डिफरेंट, 6 months थियरी एंड 6 months प्रैक्टिस, दैट इज़ 50-50%. सो इट दैट इट सेल्फ इज यू नो लाइक वील गेट फर्स्ट हैंड एक्सपीरियंस एंड वी आर सीइंग द लिविंग डॉक्यूमेंट्स. सो दैट इज़ मोर इम्पॉर्टेंट मोर देन थियरी पार्ट.
So the whole environment is, whether you're a medical professional, whether you're a law professional, whether you're a social science professional, social work professional, the perspective was that we all need to work together to make things happen. And this was a reflection on what we saw in the ground. Because for a community person, health is very related to their economic status. It's very related to their knowledge on medical issues. It's very related to their social networks which they have, whether they are able to access a certain facility or not.
Education ho ya politics ho ya economic status, ek dusre se itne interconnected hain. Agar ek bhi aap किसी भी उसको अगर छोड़ते हो, अगर अलग हटाते हो, तो आप कंप्लीट हेल्थ फॉर ऑल की तरफ नहीं बढ़ सकते, सबके स्वास्थ्य की तरफ नहीं बढ़ सकते.
Like with their collective sessions or the interactions with mentors, and especially the constant reminder that you have to go to the community and not the community come to you, and you know, understanding the community, that's the main thing, and not going as an expert but trying and being part of the community. When I went into the field, I learned that it was very important to listen to the people, not just what they're saying but also through their actions. I learned to decipher a lot of things that people could not necessarily communicate.
स्वास्थ्य लोगों के हाथ में, इसका मतलब यह है कि हर इंसान को अपने स्वास्थ्य के प्रति जागरूक होना चाहिए. हर इंसान को अपने स्वास्थ्य के प्रति एक शो, मतलब एक डिमांड करना चाहिए, उसको लेना, मतलब उसका अधिकार है. तो इसलिए ये चीज़ उसके हाथ में है, ये उसको जानना चाहिए, और जब भी ये उसको प्राप्त कर सकता है, वो अपनी उसको ज़रूरत भी समझेगा और उसके लिए कुछ कार्य भी करेगा.
सो इट्स ऑल अबाउट गोइंग देयर, बिकमिंग पार्ट ऑफ द कम्युनिटी एंड देन ट्राइंग टू यू नो हेल्प द कम्युनिटी हेल्प देमसेल्व्स.
इट्स जस्ट नॉट अ डिजीज वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट. इन सोचारा वी वर टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ पॉवर्टी हैज़ लेड टू टीबी. सो देयर वॉज अ सोशल डिटर्मिनेंट ऑफ हेल्थ which was related to directly diseases and which was being ignored by many of health professionals.
वैसे लोगों के लिए जो कम्युनिटी में रह के कम्युनिटी के बारे में सोचते हैं और कम्युनिटी के लिए कुछ करने की तमन्ना है उनके, तो उनके लिए ये प्रोग्राम सचमुच में बहुत ही उपयुक्त है, क्योंकि यहाँ से जो सीख करके जा करके बिल्कुल कुछ परिवर्तन ला सकते हैं. ये उनकी क्षमता वृद्धि में बहुत ही सहयोग करेगा. ये
the main thing is we have to be humble enough, and we have to be with the people, and there are times that we have to pretend that we don't know anything, because the community, they learn so many things and they can even solve the problem of their own, but they just need a guide or they just need a supervision. So I have learned that if we go to the community, we have to be like a lamp or a candle, not as a chandelier. That if we go to the community, I should not say that I am a community health worker, I am a social worker, I am a doctor or whatever.
What is really development? Are we talking about infrastructure in terms of high-rise buildings and roads, or are we going to talk about basic necessities like catering to food, health and security of the people? So Sochara made me think about all these problems in a very different lens, and I'm really grateful to the learning experience that I got from Sochara.
Illi Sochara dalli illi teach madodu yav tara irutte andre neevu swabhavana change madkobeku, neevu community hogbeku, alli community yenu ಕೊಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಅವರು ಅವ್ರಿಗೇನು ಬೇಕಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ತಿಳ್ಕೊಂಡು ಅದನ್ನು ನಾವು ಸಮುದಾಯ ಅದನ್ನು ಒದಗಿಸೋದು ನಮ್ಮ ಕರ್ತವ್ಯ ಅಂತ ಸಚಾರ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇತ್ತು. ಆದರೆ ವಾಸ್ತವಾಂಶ ಗೊತ್ತಿರೋದನ್ನು ನಮಗೆ, ಇವ್ರು ಯಾಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂದರೆ, ಇವ್ರು ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಕೂತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಏನೋ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ, ಇವರು ಸ್ಥಳೀಯವಾಗಿ ಹೋಗಿ ಏನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಕ್ರೋಧ ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ ತೀವ್ರವಾಗಿ ಬೆಳೆದಿತ್ತು. ಆದರೆ ಆ ಒಂದು ಅಂಶವನ್ನು ನಾನು ನೋಡಿದಾಗ, ವಾಸ್ತವಾಂಶ ನೋಡಿದಾಗ, ನಿಜವಾಗಿ ನನ್ನನ್ನು ನಾನೇ ಬದಲಾಯಿಸ್ಕೊಂಡೆ, ನನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಆದರೆ, ಅಂದರೆ ನನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಆದರೆ ನಾನು ಆಗ ಮಾತ್ರ ಸಮಾಜನ ಬದಲಾವಣೆ ಮಾಡಲು ನಾನು ಯೋಗ್ಯವಾದ ವ್ಯಕ್ತಿ ಅಂತೇಳಿ ಮೊದಲು ಯೋಜನೆ ಮಾಡೋ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಸಿಚುವೇಶನ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಪರಿಸ್ಥಿತಿ ಹೆಂಗಿದೆ, ಈ ಸ್ಥಿತಿಯನ್ನು ನಾವು ಬದಲಾಯಿಸ್ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಾವು ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ಸ್ಪಂದಿಸಬೇಕು ಅನ್ನೋ ಒಂದು ಸ್ಪಂದನೆಯನ್ನು ನಾನು ಕಲಿತೆ ಸ್ವಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ.
I was seeing this problems of the people, and sometimes I would go by my emotions, but after completing this course I have learned, like, I have to go through the way that I may reason out and do the analysis, then find the solution.
From a background of medical science, I am a health professional now, and all thanks goes to Sochara.
Here at Sochara, I learned how to move from being an intracellularist to a balloonist, and here I learned as a balloonist to look at the problems from a wider angle. And though I learned that it's very important to focus on bigger issues, it's important to work at the grassroots level with the people, listening to them and understanding their heard and unheard needs. The collective sessions that have happened out in Sochara have really changed my perspective or thinking about health. Being from a medical background, the biomedical approach has changed completely now. The paradigm shift has happened.
जब हम लोगों के लिए काम करते हैं तो अंदर से एक बहुत अच्छा लगता है कि ज़िंदगी में कुछ ऐसी चीज़ें होती हैं जो हमने अपने स्वार्थ से हटके की। और यहाँ पे हम लोगों को यही सिखाया जाता है कि यदि हमको दूसरों के स्वास्थ्य के लिए कुछ काम करना है तो खुद के स्वास्थ्य का ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा। और जब हम ये काम करते हैं तो हमारा आध्यात्मिक स्वास्थ्य भी काफ़ी उन्नत होता है। हमको समझ में आता है कि दुनिया में सब एक हैं, और यदि कम्युनिटी हेल्थ में समझना है तो सबको एक बराबर मानना पड़ेगा।
The CHC Library and Information Center, CILC, is a resource center in the area of community health, public health, health policy and development. CILC has an extensive collection of books, journals, newsletter, health education materials and magazines, reports, booklets by NGOs, governments and international bodies. The center also has some rare books from the personal collection of senior health professionals.
For too long, health and healthcare have been dominated by medical control and by professional control, and also by commercial interest, especially over the past couple of decades. This has to change. Health is really something that's in everybody's hands. It's also everybody's right. And so therefore there is a need for a completely different approach to training of health professionals. Setting up the third phase of the community health learning program through SOFIA is one such attempt, but we are now hoping to mainstream this across the universities as well as other educational institutions. During the past year, we've been linked with the Rajiv Gandhi University of Health Sciences in evolving a very unique curriculum for a 3-year Masters in Public Health program, which has taken on many of the approaches that the CHLP has. This to us is a very important part of mainstreaming, because this is not something that can be done as an island. I think this is something that's necessary for everybody in this country as well as elsewhere.